All right, so for E, I have P, and I'm just going to say that P obviously has the highest bonding preference because phosphorus can make three bonds, likes to make three bonds, and bromine only likes to make one. So I'm just going to make three bonds to bromine. And then I'm going to add in all the electrons to fill the octets. And then phosphorus also needs to fill its octet. And it likes to have five electrons because it's in column five, or it's in the fifth group. So that's perfect. That's going to be, it's going to want to have one lone pair. Now when I calculate formal charges, let's just calculate formal charges to make sure I did it right. Bromine is fine, and phosphorus is also fine. This is the Lewis structure. Okay? Now what I want to do is see, are there any dipoles? And it turns out that I have so many lone pairs that this is going to be a disaster. There's going to be dipoles going everywhere. But what's important to note is that the bromines are going to be pulling in different directions, and then I'm going to have a lone pair pulling in an opposite direction. Does that make sense so far? You're right. There are other dipoles with all of those lone pairs. They're making other dipoles as well. Okay? But I'm just focusing on the major ones because already with the major ones, we're going to see something that's really important, which is that, are these going to perfectly cancel out? No, they aren't, because I have dipoles pulling at bromine that are a different strength than a lone pair dipole. Okay? On top of that, I didn't even draw this correctly. Okay? If you were to figure out the hybridization of this, and I'm just combining everything, but if you were to figure out the hybridization of this phosphorus, what you would find out is that the hybridization is sp3. Since it has one lone pair, you'd find out that it has a shape of pyramidal. So what that means is that what it actually looks like is this: P with a lone pair with a bromine in the front, a bromine in the back, and a bromine on a stick. Okay, remember that I said pyramidal kind of looks like a pyramid? So that's a pyramid. So these guys are pulling down, and they're not perfectly canceling out because they're all pulling down, and then you have a phosphorus lone pair pulling up, but it's possibly not as strong, or it's possibly too strong. We don't need to calculate the difference of the lone pair. All we need to know is that this is not perfectly balancing out, so yes, it has a net dipole. Does that make sense? So I combined a lot of different concepts together to get to the conclusion that yes, this must have a net dipole. CO2, this one hopefully is a little easier. C goes in the middle, O on one side, O on one side. I do lone pairs. Okay, and what I find out is that I'm going to have a negative 2 here, I'm going to have a negative 1 here, and I'm going to have a negative 1 there. Ugh, and I'm drawing right over myself. Sorry about that. So guys, just so you know, this is what I was drawing. Go ahead and pause it if you couldn't see it. So notice that I have a negative 2 in the middle, negative 1, negative 1. What's so great about formal charges? What does this tell us about what we have to do? Make double bonds. So this means that I need to make one double bond here. That's going to turn this one to negative 1, and this one to 0. And then I have to make one double bond there, which is going to turn this one to 0, and this one to 0. Does that make sense? Because negative 2 meant that I need two new double bonds, and negative 1 on each side means that each side needs to have 1. This is going to turn into C, double bond O, double bond O. All right, and I know that's like right over my head again. So now we have to look at dipoles. Well, are there any dipoles? Yes, the O's are pulling away from the carbon. All right, and then we also have the lone pairs pulling in these directions. Okay, now notice that if we were to do, in these you do have to look at the hybridization because the hybridization tells you the shape. So if I were to look at the shape of that, what is it called when it has two bond sites? That would be called SP or linear. So did I draw it correctly? Yes, I did. And what that means is that these dipoles are all going to perfectly cancel out because this is linear, so they're pulling in perfectly opposite directions. So that means this one's going to have no net dipole. Crazy, right? So listen, when I give you the shape of a molecule, you don't have to worry about geometry so much. Okay, so in this case, I gave it to you. But when you're doing a Lewis structure, you absolutely need to figure out what the geometry is. Why? Because that could totally change things. That could totally make it either perfectly cancel out or maybe not cancel out, based on how you draw it, based on the shape. Okay? And that's one of the reasons that hybridization is really important.